Hi, my friend. It is Woodland Wonderland Day. I'm Pat Sloan, and we are on Chapter 5. There are two things in Chapter 5, and I'm going to split them into 2 weeks. After that, I think the next one we'll do like in 2 weeks, the next chapter, and then after that, we get into setting things in January so that we can have it all done by the end of January. I think that's where we're going to go with this. So this week, we will be creating the flower stems. There's two of them here and up here, these two flower stems. In the same chapter is the stinking cute gnome. Oh my goodness, he's so cute. But next week, we're gonna do the flowers first. You've done the leaves, but if you didn't do the leaves, you're gonna do the leaves this week and create those whole stems. So here are the two flower parts that you need to make for in the middle of that stem part. And I have to show you the gnome. Next week I'll make a red gnome, of course. red, everything red. Isn't he so cute? Looks like a little, like one of those children's toys that had the round bottoms that you like, you know, they went sideways. What were those called? Tippy toys somehow? They have a name. I would say round bottom toys, that's not it. But there he is. Now, if you get over ambitious and you do all of these and you want to do that too, yes, you can. So this is the chapter that we will split into two parts. The leaves, I'm gonna lay out the leaves here because that is one where I think if we're not on our A game, you're gonna get a leaf turned the wrong way, which is still fine, nature's fine, but I like the look of the leaves the way they are. So they are all going one direction on the left and the other direction on the right, and I want them to look just like the picture. Okay. Now, if you have the kit, so if you've bought the kit and you're doing the autumn version like I am, then on the back, you know, in the kit, rather, you get your chart that tells you all the fabrics, and we're using this gray fabric for the stems. So that is this fabric here, and that's what I'll pull out for the stems. But I'm just going to show out, just put the leaves. The leaves are also sort of scrappy. So because they're also scrappy, that means I want to vary how I use them. You know, I don't want a bunch of the same ones right next to each other. And so on each side, there's 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 4 sets on either side of the flower, and then you'll do that twice. So when you're laying it out, and I would use either design board and just do one, you know, one set like here. You're going to have this together, right? And there is the where the stem will go. So you've got them all going. No, they go like this. Here I am doing it wrong. This is too. I'm like looking at that thinking. See, this is where you have to be on your A game. This is too short. There's only a stem that goes in between. So don't sew it like this. Oh my goodness! Should I just cut that video part out or leave it in? Okay, so this is how you're sewing it. So when you're laying it out, they should look pretty good. Now these are backwards. So now I need to, are they backwards? No, this one goes up here. Okay. Should I start this whole video over? No, I'm gonna do this. Okay, this one now is like that green is to the green, the same green. I don't want that. So I'm gonna flip that. Okay, these are now going the correct way. This one actually will have a spacer. So they're offset a little bit. There's a spacer here, and then when you finish this row, there'll be a spacer at the end. Whew, that was a workout. Okay, these, I have these stacked. So up here, they're all the same, and down here, they're all the same, right? So, same direction, but I want to get the fabrics different. So I've got a bunch of deer there. I want to get one without a deer. So I've got one without a deer, and then I could put a deer again. And then one without the deer, and it's got plaid. Where's the plaid ones? Okay, now these are all going the same way. See, I want to be sure they're all going the same way. Now I want to do here the same thing. I don't want to put the fabrics that are exactly the same right next to each other. So I'll see what else I have. I've got a plaid there. There's a lot of plaids I did on this side, and then another plaid. There we go. So this is how the stem will look. And double, triple, quadruple check everything so that you know this is totally right. It looks like, I'm just looking at the diagram. I haven't, there is, yeah, one side goes right up to the top, but there's another, might be another little sliver in there. So we've got to check that. So the biggest part is getting all of these leaves going the way that you want them. Okay. Then you repeat. I am actually just going to do one at a time. I will go and sort these so that I don't end up with the last one. All the fabric combinations are exactly the same. That would make me very unhappy. So I will sort these into three more sets, these three sets and these three sets, so that there's a variety and I don't end up with all the same fabrics for one of the sections. A little tip is that I cut out a bigger section. It was a little bit more than 14 and a fourth, and a little wider than the four strips I needed. I cut that out first from the bigger piece because I find it a little bit easier to work with. I trimmed the length to the size and I'm subcutting my stems. Now, if you find it hard to see it on here, you can always reverse it to the lighter side. See how much better that is? It's so much easier on the eyes to see it this way. And then I'm cutting all these strips out. So I have four stems that will be right down here. And then remember, there are background pieces between the leaves, so don't be sewing your leaves right to each other. I put them on the bigger design board. Per the instructions, they are all the same. You make all four sections exactly the same, so I could lay them out. So I just stacked everything, I sorted them, then stacked them. There's one section that's wider. And then remember, these strips goes in between. That strip goes on the end over there, and I'm ready to go. We are back. Look at this. This is so fabulous. I love it. I could just see like these could be in all kinds of quilts. Like you could put them in the border of quilts. So that's what's kind of fun is when you have a pattern that has a lot of components, like the Woodland Wonderland, you can look at those components and see how you might use them somewhere else. This would just make a fabulous border. Just not even, doesn't have to be the full border. It could be like one in the middle of the top and the top, you can't see it. Top and the bottom, the sides. So I did both of them. Proof. Show it or it didn't happen, right? Yeah, so here they are. They're both of them done. Now I'm also going to cut up some more mushrooms in the red. So I did pick some fabric for that. I only did one mushroom so far, one large mushroom. So I'm going to do, I think, a large and a small with this, and a small with this dot, and then use that wonderful stripe that was gifted to me, and for that, and then some dots for with the flowers. So that will be, here's the other one I have that was in the painting that Sharon did. So I'm going to do all five because these go over top of this flower. So eventually, I think I'll do the flower in the reds, and then maybe I'll just do like some sort of, I don't know what I'm going to do with the reds. I'm just playing around, and I don't know. I would love to make like the whole quilt in the red, but then I'd love to do a lot of other quilts. So honestly, I don't know what I'm going to do. I'll just see how many I get done by the end of this, whole process of taping through making the autumn version and see what it looks like. So here's the autumn version. I want to put it up again because this is a kit that I'm working with, with the super cute little gnome in the green and the orange cap. So cute. So this is the kit, and you can still get a kit. I don't know how many are left, but after the sales over the Black Friday, there might not be as many left. So you want to grab one if you want it. The kits have all these directions, so that for placement. It also has a pattern included. It's just fabulous. It's something you can work on just on your own, even. Okay, for those of you who are not familiar with Bring Home the Tree, this is a sew along we did, I think, in 2019. I think it was 2019. I love it. This is in a book called Vintage Christmas, which has zillions of projects in it, so many awesome projects. And so that is a fabulous book. If you don't have it, you should. You should get that one. So I will link you that my website to this and down in the description box here at YouTube. Okay, first I have a little mail call, and then I want to show you some other other quilts that I was just shuffling, and I thought, okay, I'll bring this little stack in here and show you. So first I got a little mail call. This is from Stephanie. Look, she sent me Band-Aids, a card with Band-Aids for my my face, and then some gorgeous gray and gold yellow fabrics. Aren't those beautiful? I love this one. Look at that. Whoops, here. Look at that. I just really, really love that one. And then here's one that has gray and yellow. So pretty. Thank you, Stephanie. And then I have another one today from Mary Beth. Mary Beth is always. I think you're always here, Mary Beth, in the mornings. And so she sent this super cute, look, super cute little card with the bee. Look at that, this little dimensional card. My mom would love this. My mother loves pop-up cards. She got into pop-up cards, and for a while she sent me tons of them, and then I started sending them to her. So I'm gonna go have to find a new pop-up card. This one's so cute. Anyway, Mary Beth also made me an amazing journal. She covered it with my Morrison Park fabric. Look, she did a little pencil holder, which has, look, there's a Christmas pen in it. That's so cute. It has an elastic to keep it shut. Look at that. And the inside also is the Morrison Park. Mwah. Thank you, thank you, thank you for these wonderful gifts. They are so precious. That journal is nice. I love it. Love it, love it. Okay, some other things that I have. This was I guess they're quilts from the vault. this is a Dresden that I did for the button club, since it has buttons on it, a while back. You know, I did the button club for a long time. I did projects for it for the Fat Quarter Shop. If you just do Google search Pat Sloan Buttons Club, you'll find them pretty much. I have a tab, but it's sort of like you have to scroll back through post after post, but it's still doable. And then I did embroidery in the middle. Happy Holly Days, and the little holly, where is it? The holly here, yeah, and the button. So the get that effect, you do every other blade the same as your background. So it's a regular Dresden with no points, and then every other blade is just your same color as the background to give you this floating effect, which is so fun. I love it. Then I have a couple small things that I've done. This is one, somebody actually mentioned doing this the other day. They're little mug rugs. So if you are right now looking for little mug rug ideas for winter gifts, for give for a little Christmas present, these don't take long to do. And I did the little gingerbread and gingerbread girl, you know, boy and girl. These also are ways to use up your cute buttons that you've been saving. Look at that. She's holding a little house. He has a little tree. I'll also link you to the buttons at the Fat Quarter Shop, because there are still collections out there. Just Another Button Company is where those come from. A lot of them are hand molded, such as the tree and the little gingerbread. These are all hand molded by people for Just Another Button Company. Okay, the other two are Halloween fabrics, but you don't have to do them in Halloween fabrics. So that's why I wanted to show you them to you, because there are ones that I think when sometimes we see a quilt in a particular colorway for a particular, like we're making fall quilts or whatever, then you sort of forget about the fact that those quilts would be fabulous in other ways. Now, we did do this one, or very similar to this, I did for Shamrocks last year. You know, we converted one of the circles. This is a free pattern. We converted one of these, I converted to lines, and so we did four shamrocks. And yesterday when we were doing green quilts, a couple people showed that. But this quilt is super fun for doing in any kind of colors, using up those little extra squares you have. It could be scrappy. You could do many more blocks than this, so you could do a big quilt. You know, I think it's just the actual block itself, like how many are on there? 4, 8, that's 16. I don't know how many 30 or 31 would be for a block a day, but if you were doing just one of these a day, and then starting to set it, this could be a block a day quilt, like we're gonna do one in March. I'm sort of collecting ideas for that. So all of those are free patterns. I'm hoping I can find this Christmas one and post it. I'll look and see if I can find that one still. I think I can. And the last one is my pattern. It's a paid pattern. It's a digital pattern called Stitched, and it uses a jelly roll. The pattern comes in many sizes, so there's like three different sizes that you can do, and this is super fun for jelly rolls. You can also just cut your own strip sets of 2.5-inch strips, which would be the same width as a jelly roll strip. And then you find some sort of great background fabric. I love doing the dots. This is kind of a medium-sized dot. This one also had this fabulous vintagey looking holiday fabric that I put on the back of it, and I used it all up there. So it's like I can never get rid of that quilt because I love that fabric. It's mine. I can't give it to anybody else. Okay, you're going to make flowers. You should have the leaves already done, but it still takes a little while to put these together, so that'll be a good thing for this week. And then next week, we will do the gnome. I love you. Mwah. See you online.